Sustainer, O Lord, as the one who created the universe and created us too in your image and in your likeness. How wonderful you are, O God. How worthy you are to receive all honor, glory, and praise. Father, let your Spirit, whom you have left for your church, fill us, empower us, teach us, guide us, show us your way. Through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
Today's scripture reading is taken from Jeremiah chapter 32 verses 1 to 15. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord in the 10th year of Zedekiah, king of Judah, which was the 18th year of Nebuchadnezzar. From then, the king of Babylon's army besieged Jerusalem, and Jeremiah the prophet was shut up in the court of the prison, which was in the king of Judah's house. For Zedekiah, king of Judah, had shut him up, saying, "Why do you prophesy and say, 'This says the Lord'? Behold, I will give this city into the hand of the king of Babylon, and he shall take it. And Zedekiah, king of Judah, shall not escape from the hand of the Chaldeans, but shall surely be delivered into the hand of the king of Babylon, and shall speak with him face to face, and see him eye to eye. Then he shall lead Zedekiah to Babylon, and there he shall be until I visit him, says the Lord. Though you fight with the Chaldeans, you shall not succeed." And Jeremiah said, "The word of the Lord came to me, saying, 'Behold, Hanamel, the son of Shallum, your uncle, will come to you, saying, "Buy my field, which is in Anatot, for the right of redemption is yours to buy it." Then Hanamel, my uncle's son, came to me in the court of the prison, according to the word of the Lord, and said to me, "Please buy my field that is in Anatot, which is in the country of Benjamin, for the right of inheritance is yours, and the redemption yours. Buy it for yourself." Then I knew that this was the word of the Lord. So I bought a field from Hanamiel, the son of my uncle, who was in Anatoth, and weighed out to him the money, 17 shekels of silver. And I signed the deed and sealed it, took witness and weighed the money on the scales. So I took the purchase deed, both which was sealed according to the law and custom, and that which was open. And I gave the purchase deed to Baruch, the son of Neriah, son of Messiah, in the presence of Hanamiel, my uncle's son, and in the presence of the witness who signed the purchase deed, before all the Jews who sat at the port of the prison. Then I charged Baruch before them, saying, Thus say the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, take these deeds, both this purchase deed which is sealed, and this deal which is open, and put them in an earthen vessel, that they may last many days. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, houses and fields and vineyards shall be possessed again in this land. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his holy word. Amen.
Of sovereign power, come shake the earth again, that man may see and come with reverent fear to the living God, whose kingdom shall outlast the years. Restore, O Lord, your fame, and in our time revive the church that bears your name. And in your anger, Lord, remember mercy, your living God, whose mercy shall outlast the years.
Let us come to Almighty God in prayer. By the power of your Holy Spirit, O Lord, inspire us, teach us, show us your way. Fill us, O Lord, and guide us in every way, that we may do your will, and that we may become all that you created us to be. And now may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our strength, our Saviour, and our Redeemer. Amen. Do you have faith in God? We perhaps all said a resounding yes. How do we put that faith into practice? And what is the evidence of that faith? That probably will take much longer if we are to answer honestly. In the book of Jeremiah, from the passage that was read to us today, We heard of an example of someone who had faith and who put that faith into practice. Jeremiah purchased a piece of land. That doesn't seem to be anything strange. It doesn't seem to be anything extraordinary. But when we understand the circumstances under which Jeremiah bought that land, then we begin to see a true definition and demonstration of his faith and his trust in God. When Jeremiah bought that land, he was in jail. He was jailed under the Babylonian Empire. And he had the opportunity to purchase this piece of land from his cousin, which he did. But what was happening at the time is that Jerusalem, the Jewish people, were being destroyed. The temple had been destroyed. The leaders of Israel were being taken into exile, into captivity. And all future hope for Israel seemed lost. One never knew what was going to happen. The future was unsure. It was under these circumstances that Jeremiah bought a piece of land in a war-torn Jerusalem. My dear friends, an act of Jeremiah to buy this land based on a vision that he had gotten from God was evidence of his faith in God. And not evidence that was just based on words, but it was backed up with action. He purchased the land, he made deeds, he secured the deeds, he made sure persons know where the deeds were. Even under those traumatic circumstances where the future was uncertain. Indeed, my dear friends, faith is very important. It is vital to the Christian life. But what is faith? According to Webster's dictionary, faith is an unquestioning belief that does not require proof or evidence. But although that is what Webster described faith as Christians, we have evidence for our faith. We have the Bible with 66 books written by 40 authors with three languages over a period of 1600 years, filled with prophecies that have come true and moral and spiritual truths. We have the resurrection of Jesus Christ. We have confidence in his words and evidence of God's truth in our lives. The nearest definition we have in the Bible of what faith is found in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 1. The NIV version says, "Now faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see." A literal translation from the Greek says, "Now faith is the reality of things we hope for, the proof of things not seen." This is exactly what Jeremiah's act of faith reflected. His act of faith reflected a hope that was not seen and could not be seen because of the circumstances that Israel was under. His purchase of the piece of land under those negative circumstances proved his faith and trust in God. An important point that we must note, though, is that faith is only as good as the object in which it is placed. All the faith in the world in someone false won't help us. But how does faith reveal itself in our daily lives? How does it affect our daily lives? Because we all practice faith on a daily basis. We get in the car and drive on faith. We don't know if we are going to make it to our destination alive or not. But we go. We have faith that the food we buy that is grown by strangers is not harmful, so we eat it. We have faith that the doctors we see are competent, so we put ourselves and our lives in their hands. Today, we put our faith in the authorities that the advice that they are giving us to deal with COVID-19 is reliable. So we wear masks, we sanitize, we social distance, and all of the other things that we have been advised to do. If we did not have faith, if we did not trust others, we wouldn't be able to drive, eat, or get help in times of sickness and trouble. Our lives would be very difficult without some measure of faith. Let us now see how faith affected some of God's people in God's words. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 4 says, "By faith, Abel offered God a better sacrifice than Cain did. By faith, he was commended as a righteous man, and when God spoke well of his offerings. And by faith, he still speaks, even though he is dead." My dear friends, there is something drastically wrong with the Christian who does not worship. Faith causes us to look for every opportunity to worship. Again, in the Bible, we hear that faith made Enoch walk with God. We are told by faith, Enoch was taken from this life so that he did not experience death. He could not be found because God had taken him away. For before he was taken, he was commended as one who pleased God. My dear friends, our walk will change too if we continue to have faith and trust in Christ Jesus. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come." The question for us today, my dear friends, do we practice our faith? And how do we practice our faith? Is God pleased with the places we choose for recreation? Is God pleased with the books we read and what we watch on TV or Netflix? Is God pleased with the words we use in public and in private, the conversations we have? Is God pleased with the plans we have made for our future? Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6 tells us, "And without faith, it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who are earnestly seeking him." Faith connects us to God. It is our admission that we depend upon him, that our hope is in him. It pleases him because it is him we are putting our trust in, and no one and nothing else. Faith, my dear friends, is vitally important to the life of a Christian. It is by faith that we are saved, that we are justified, that we are cleansed, and look forward to the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Faith is where we please God, admit our dependence upon him, and continually seek to rely on him and his grace. Let us answer this question. What has faith changed in our lives? What are the evidences of our faith in our lives? Is faith growing in our lives? Let us, my dear friends, follow the example of the prophet Jeremiah, who even though was under hopeless circumstances, found his hope in his faith in God. As we face this pandemic, as we face all of the challenges as a nation and as a church and as a people, let us to exercise that faith. A faith that is not only mere words, but a faith that is translated into our practices, our acts, our deeds, every single moment of every single day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Looks up to thee, thou Lamb of Calvary, Saviour divine. Now hear me while I pray, take all my guilt away. Be holy thine. May thy rich grace impart strength to my fainting heart, my zeal inspire. Tread and griefs around me spread, be thou my guide. Mid darkness turn to day, wipe sorrow's tears away.
Trust in you, and who believe, O God, in the presence of your Holy Spirit, whom you have left for us to be our teacher and our guide. Father, your deeds of the past are the evidences of our faith in the future. And now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us. And all of God's people, wherever they may be, both now and even forevermore.